Today, lab will give you practice implementing sorting algorithm by using MathMaker like the previous one. The sorting algorithm that you need to implement is merge sort and quick sort. In this lab, when you implement the merge sort you must to implement the merge function. The merge function will merge two subarrays to form a sorted array. And in the merge sort function, will be partition the array into the subarrays and then use the merge sort and use the merge function to merge two subarrays to form a sorted array. And in the quick sort, you need to implement the partition function. The partition function will partition the array into three parts. The first one is keyword. Keyword is selected the element in the array, and the second part is the subarray that contain element that less than the keyword, and the third part is the array that contains all element that greater than keyword. The detail of the to implement the merge sort and quick sort. First one, you must implement the merge sort. I will teach you later. And second is implement the quick sort function. You can use algorithm in the data structure with the programming textbook, or you can use in the your lecture. To implement the partition function and the quick sort function. And then you apply the merge sort and quick sort to a list of random number. And don't forget to upload your notebook file, that is the MathMaker file to LAB2 to get your score. These are the things that you need to do. Then I will explain you how to implement the merge sort in the MathMaker. Usually, when you implement merge sort in the C programming, you will use the recursive. You must create the recursive function of merge sort. But in the MathMaker, you can use another form of recursive. Algorithm to the built-in function of MathMaker. To implement the merge sort, first we need to focus on the merge function to combine two subarrays to form a sorted array. For example, when we have the two subarrays 39 and 9, we can combine them to the sorted array by 9 and 39 as the elements of the sorted array. To implement this function, I will use which function will perform like the nested if else. There are or it's similar to the switch case. It's the define of the which function. There are text for many pairs of the parameter, the first pair is test one and value one, the second is test two and value two, and so on. The test is the condition of statement, conditional statement, and value is the value that you need to return. If you see this function, I specify the right. The right variable is the right subarray, and the left variable is the left subarray. And I use switch to implement the nested if else or switch case. The first case is the left index more than the length of the left subarray. Then we need to copy the element in the right subarray, and then increase the right index. The left and right index will be start from one if we use Mathematica, and if you use the C programming, the left and right index will be start from zero. It's different from the programming language when we use the index to start. And the second condition is right index is more than length of right subarray. Then we will copy the element of the left array and increase the left index. The first two conditions will perform after all elements of one subarray is already copied to the sorted array, and there is another one left. And next two condition is performed when the two subarray contain have element left. Then the third condition of the this function will be the element of left subarray and element of right array will be compared. If the element of left subarray is less than or equal right subarray, then copy left subarray, copy element of left subarray and increase the left index. And then otherwise, copy the right subarray, element of right subarray and increase the right index. This condition is equal to the element of right subarray is less than element of left subarray. This is the part of the algorithm in the merge function. Wait a minute, I forgot to send you a NB file. If you use Mathematica standalone, you can use the my NB file to open and follow me like this. And if you use the use web, you must try to write after me, and there is no pattern of the NB file. To implement the wish function that is in the merge function, then the first condition left in the more than the length of left. This is the first test or the statement, conditional statement. Or in the C programming, you can notice that it is the first if. And then after the condition is satisfied, you can return the value of the element of the right subarray. So you can use right and index like this, and then to increase the right index, you can use plus plus symbol to increase the right index like this. If you remember when you write the C programming, the prefix operation will be performed like this. The element of the right index will be returned, and then right index will be increased by one. Then second condition, we use right index and use length function to evaluate the length of the right subarray or left sub array. And you can see the color of the variable left index and left index is the blue because the program don't know what is the array and the value of if there is no register, there is not just register. And when the program know the function, it will turn to black. Then in this function, I will write only and I will not evaluate them or run them. The second case is the line index is more than left length of line subarray, and then I will return the element of left subarray and then increase the left index. And next step, next conditional statement is the element of left subarray is less than element of right subarray. Then return the element of left subarray. Don't forget to increase the left index. The last conditional statement I use otherwise. So if you write in the C programming, you can use else, but in the Mathematica, do not the else statement. So you can use which by given the condition is true, but for this condition is true. This is the main part of the merge function. This part is fine to copy the element of subarray to subarrays into the sorted array. If you finish to implement, is implementing this function, so we will go to the next step. The next step is to generate the array, the sorted array. We will use the table function to create the list or array of the sorted element. You can see this example. The table function is called, and which function in here is you can copy this code into this part. This part is the expression for generate the element of the array, and the second part is the number of element that you need to generate. We will combine two function and implement the merge function. Then before I implement the merge function, I will show you how. This is an example of use the table. I think to clarify how to use the table that contains the list function, we need to implement the merge function. The merge function will take two parameters. The first one is left subarray, and the second one is right subarray. You can specify the left and right variable are the array or list variable by add the keyword list like this, or you can ignore the keyword list. I declare two variables. These are left index and right index, and initial them to one. And then use the table function to generate the array, the sorted array. and then you can copy the this code and pass it pass inside the table function. This code will be the expression for generate the element of the sorted array. And this part will tell the function, the table function that you need to you need to how many repetition you need to perform. When you put the with table with function into the table and you declare the number of repetition to generate the element in the sorted array it will complete the merge to write the merge function. Be careful when you have to this point, you should not add the semicolon, because the table will generate the sorted array and then return from the merge function. If you put the semicolon here, yeah, the merge function will not return anything. So you need to remove the semicolon for the table function. The table function will automatically return the list of the sorted elements. And then run the merge function, so you can see the blue color of the merge name will be black. And I declare the left of LA. Left and right to be the event number 2, 4, and 6. And then call the merge function. You can see the result. The left sub array is contains 1, 3, and 5 elements, and right sub array is contain 2, 4, and 6. And then when we call the merge function to merge left sub array and right sub array, it will be the sorted array as the output 6. I will show you if you put the semicolon at the end of the table function. When you run, you can see I run this input 7, and when I run, it will change to 11. That there is new run, and then I run the merge again. You can see that there is no output appear. So when you remove the semicolon, เดี๋ยวคุณวิวบีโชนOr you can declare the bucket list array and assign the value of table, the return of value table function to the sorted list like this, and you put the semicolon and then return.Return the sorted list.The output will be shown like before. If you notice, the table function will perform like like for function when it can use instead of the for loop. You can changeThe table function to be for loop. Why the table function can generate why the table function can generate the element of sorted array.When okay, if you see and the first element of left and right is 1 and 2, when you compare the first element of both subarray, the condition.Will be satisfied in the third condition like this, and okay, I set left index equal 1 and right index equal 1 and then I run this code. You can see that this code will return 1. This the which condition will return 1 and then it is the expression to be the element in the table. Okay. Do you get it? Then which will return the element, and then when the left index is equal one and right index is equal one, it will return one, and then the one will be the element of the new list that generated by the table function. Okay, you can see this is the first condition. When this condition is satisfied, it will be print con 1. And if the second condition is satisfied, it will print con 2 and so on. So I will run again. You can see that when the left index is equal 1 and right index is equal 1, then the first condition will be satisfied and then return the first element of left array. And then one will be the element of the sorted list that generated by the table function. Then you can see the structure of the table function. The first is the expression. The expression will be generate the element of the list by substitute I, and I will form 1, 2, 3, and then when you run this function, it will be the list that contains 1, 4, and 9. Well, let's say that for the first condition, whether it's return one, when you merge the subarrays, two subarrays, you need to form the sorted array, right? And then the third condition is satisfied. So it means that the element of the left subarray will be less than the element of the right subarray. Then you need to copy the element of the subarray into the sorted array first. And I will show you the value of the left index after the which function is performed. you can see that which will return one. This is the first element of the left subarray because it is less than the element of the right subarray, and left index will be returned to because the first operation will be add or increment the value lesser than it is than the statement. Then in this line if the left index will be one, still be one, and after it perform to return the value, the left index will be changed by incrementing the value its value. If I change the postfix operator to be the prefix operator, it will return 3. 3 is the second element of the left subarray because this operation will be done first. It means that the left index will be increased by one first, and then the element of the left subarray will be returned. Then it will return the second element of the left subarray. So it returns 3. In C programming, the massage in math maker and C programming will be different. This is the first part, the merge function, the merge function of the merge sort. The merge function in C and the Mathematica, I think will be similar, but the C will be used only index and we use pointer and we can change the value in the array directly by using pointer and or using the address in the memory, but in the Mathematica you can create a concrete way to merge the array into sorted array. But in C programming you can create the new sorted array again. For the merge sort function, In common language, programming language, the index will be used to swap the value of the array, value of the element in the array. But in Mathematica, you have the many utility function to handle the array. So you can generate the many sub array in the first part to create the sub array and then merge. But in the merge function will be the same for two programming. But it's focused on another thing. C programming focus on the index, but Mathematica can focus on to handle the array. And table function can be used as for loop. So when you need to use for loop instead of table function, I declare the len variable to be the length of the sorted array. The length of the sorted array will be the length of sub array and the length of left sub array plus length of the right sub array. And they use for loop. Then declare the sorted list. The sorted list will be initial first. So I simplify initially sorted list by use table again. I initial by the null value, then the sorted list I will be assigned by which function. And then return sorted list. must change the left index. Okay. Because previously I changed the postfix operator to be the prefix operator, and I change back, it will run correctly. Then you can see that we can use table. You can use table as the for loop. This is the merge function. And next, how to implement the merge sort function. Then the first step to implement the merge sort function, you need to partition the array into two sub areas. For the first list, for the first array will be partitioned to the two sub areas like this. Then in the MathMaker, you can use the partition function for partition array into two sub areas. Then in this partition, will take more than two parameters. Then I will show you in each parameter that you need to take them. The first one, if you take two parameter list and n, then I will show you the example of the how to use the partition function. The first one, I declare list is the range 10. It will create the element from 1 to 10. Okay. There are 10 elements in this list variable, and I find the middle position of the list, and I use the link to change it to the integer value when the odd number is detected. You can see that list will be contains 1 to 10, and the mid position will be 5. In the result of the partition function from partition list from the middle position will be like this. There are two sub array. The first one is 1 to 5, and the second sub array is 6 to 10. There are two sub arrays contained in the same array. So it will change the one dimensional array to the two dimensional array. It seems work when you use the partition like this. When you use it to partition the array, the given array. But if I change the list that has 9 elements, if I change the list has 9 elements, and you can see the result of partition. It can partition only the first sub array because it fixed that the number of elements in the sub array must be 5. So the second sub array will not be generated. Then we will use the another partition function by adding the adding further variable by adding the offset d. This function you can call overloading function. That is it means that the variable the parameter can the number of parameter can be different when used in the same name of the function. And you can see the result when we use the three parameters of partition. The offset, the way of offset, I will show how. What is the offset? I will set the offset is 3. There are 9 elements in the list, and the midterm position is 5. Then, when you need to partition the subarray into the 5 elements, they contain 5 elements. The first one is correctly to partition, but the second subarray is long, and you can see the offset will tell you that there are 3 unique elements in each subarray. The first one you can see 1, 2, 3 will be only elements in the first subarray, and you can see 4 and 5 will be duplicate in the subarray in the second subarray. If you change to 4, you can see that the offset will be for the first subarray will have unique element from 1 to 4, and 5 will be duplicate for both subarrays. If you use a number mid is 5 and is the number of the element in the subarray, and mid is the offset 2, then it cannot create the second subarray like the first one. So in this function, it cannot perform partition array. And then you need to try the third partition function. Then to add more one parameter. This is a list of parameter KL and KR. KL and KR will make the partition as cyclic. So you can try by run them. You can see the second subarray. The second subarray will be add more elements. That is the first element of the first subarray. You can try to change KL and KR. If KL is 2, you can see it specifies that the first element of list should appear at position KL in the first sublist. So the first element will be 9. Okay, notion is 2. You can see that KL is 2. And the last the last element of the list out of appear at the position of KI here. So to do the partition in this algorithm, you should set the KL and KI is 1, 1, 1. But it's not satisfy the condition from for dividers the array that used in merge sort. So you need to add more parameter as the last partition function. So you need to add a blanket. This blanket will tell the partition function that to use no padding. Then the number one in the second subarray will not be filled. So when you have the nine element of in the list, and then partition by this parameter, so it will satisfy the condition of partition in the merge sort. Then the this code will be used in the merge sort function. To implement the merge sort function, we need to use two functions for represent the function as the recursive function. The first one is map function. Map function will apply the function to each element. So for the example, when you use the command like this, the map function will apply the merge sort function into the list like this. So merge sort will be applied into the list of 1, 3, 5, and the merge sort will be applied in the list of 2, 4, 6, 2. And then use apply function to take 2 subarray as input. When you use apply, you will apply with the merge function. The merge function will merge this will the merge will take two subarrays as input, as input. So when you call like this and run them, it will generate the result that you use to merge function. The output native tree will be the result of the result of use apply function. The merge function will take the two elements of the list as its input, and the output native for will be the result when you use the merge function directly. And the main part of the merge sort function will be this line. This line will be the main part of the merge sort function. In this line, the merge sort will be applied in the subarray, in this subarray, and then use merge to merge subarray into the sorted array. Why do we need apply function? In this code that I highlight, the merge sort will be recursively call itself, and the array will be partitioned into many subarrays, and then apply merge. When the first partition is performed, there are two subarrays, and then two subarrays will be taken as the input of the merge function by apply function. After we partition the array into the subarray, subarray one and subarray two, and apply will be take. I think after partition, you will get the list of sub one and sub two. It changed the one dimensional array and sorted array to be the two dimensional array that contain the subarray one and subarray two, and then it will be the list like this. Then the apply function will apply merge into this element. Or you can see that the subarray one and subarray two can we take them as the input of the merge function by using apply function. And then subarray one will be applied by merge sort again. Then subarray one will be will be partition to subarray 1-1 and subarray 1-2. And this list will be apply the merge function. Be like this. And then it will be do this process on and on. As in the same way of the subarray 1, the subarray 2 will be partitioned into sub 2 1 and sub 2 2. And then this list will be applied to the merge function by take two elements as the input of the merge function. Yes, map function is used to call merge sort recursively, yes. And apply to try to take the element of the list as its input. It will be different from map and apply. If you use map like this, it will generate the list of F1, F2, and F3, and F4. If you use apply, it will take 1, 2, 3, 4 as the input of the function. This is the difference between map and apply function. Map will be map the function into the function in each element of the array, but apply will take the element of array as its input. In partition, we need to partition the array. We need to call the map function recursive. To call the map function for make merge sort recursively. For when you use map to make the merge sort recursively to be the recursive function, the first list will be partitioned to the two subarray, and then when we use map to merge sort to take these two subarray by merge sort, the merge sort will be partitioned this subarray into two subarrays again, and then the merge sort will perform this subarray to partition into two subarrays. Here we have, assume we have array. after we partition array, it will be sub 1 and sub 2. This code, this result will be performed by this copy, this result will be performed by this command. This command partition will be generated to sub array of the array variable, and then when we use map. When we use map merge sort to the this list, this array. The merge sort will be applied to subarray 1 and subarray 2. And this result will be covered by the merge function. And how does the sub 1 be partitioned into sub 1-1? When we map the merge sort to the sub 1 and sub 2, and the result will be like this, the merge sort sub 1 will be partitioned sub 1 to sub 1-1 and sub 1-2. The merge sort sub 1 in this function will be generate the list of sub 1-1 and sub 1-2. So in this this code will be used inside the merge sort function. Yes, merge sort will call itself recursively until we get smallest array. Yes. In this slide, we'll show you the main part of the function that used in the merge sort function. But it's not the whole merge sort function. So to clear how to implement the merge sort, I think it should be like this. The merge sort we will call it recursively. So the base case of the merge sort function will be the length of the the length of the list is one. This is a best case. And the recursively condition will be the length of list is more than or equal to 2. To implement, I will declare the midterm variable. And then perform the recursive condition. This is the code of the merge sort function. So you can see the recursive condition when the length of the list is more than or equal to 2. If you determine the midterm position and then use midterm position to partition the array into two subarrays. In this function, partition array into two subarrays, and then we will use map to apply merge sort. In this function, we'll make merge sort to be the recursive function by apply merge sort into the two subarrays. After that, apply function will take the result of partition to be the input of the merge function. When the array is partitioned into the subarray that has one element, it will return the list, and then the list will be merged. Will be merged by the merge function. Don't forget to remove the semicolon after if statement. normally Merge sort will recursively partition the array. When we apply the when we use apply function to the merge function with the to sub array, it will generate the sorted array from the minimum element of array into the all array into the all element of array. The sorted array will be returned from the merge function. The merge function will cover the two sub areas. Yes, the apply function will make the input of merge function. If the list is appropriate to be the input of the merge function, the apply function will be work. So this is an example to be take the two sub array take two sub array to be the input of the merge function. If there are three elements of the array, it will not perform the merge function correctly, and then the program will stop to do anything in the merge function, because the merge function has only two inputs, but this list has three elements, so it cannot work when we use apply with the different format for the input of merge function. The map function gives each number of each index as an input. apply will take element of the list as its input, and f will be take each element as its input. Partition normally partition can make any sublist, but in this merge sort we need to partition only two subarrays. So if you after we partition into subarrays, then the map function will apply merge sort in each subarray, and then it will cover by the merge function again. Yes, สี่เวลาคุณthat's like a pivot. After each recursive, it will apply merge to the list one and list two. The partition function will partition this array into subarray, and then the map will recursively call merge sort to partition this array until the element of the subarray is one. After that, the apply function will apply the merge function to merge two subarray. And it will return the value until the sorted array is generated. This result will process by each recursion that apply merge for the list one and list two sub. And this process will form the to form is the process form mapping the merge sort to the array for to the partition array. Any question? If not, you should implement the quick sort by yourself.
It seems like we have many questions in the chat box.
To implement quick sort, you can follow by the algorithm in the textbook, and you can use normally recursive function. You can do it without the map function or apply function. And for you can put the semicolon because you can see the code in the merge sort function. You have only single statement if you can see that you have only single statement. There is if statement, and in the Mathematica it will be the functioning programming. So all of the command will be the function, and the function will return the value. So in this function if will be return value. It will return the first statement that is the condition is true, or the second statement that the condition is false. Then if you put the semicolon after if statement, it will not return the value. It will only evaluate the function but not return the value. Then if you remove the semicolon, it will return the value. Then after we evaluate the if statement, then it will return this result or the list